Hello, welcome to the stream. I'm gonna preface by saying it is hot as hell over here. So if you can hear a fan in the background, I do apologize, but I need that on for my sanity, and my own well-being, or I might just die or something. So, I'll do my best to manage that, but that fan does need to stay on. As per usual when I'm doing art streams, if anything needs to be adjusted volume-wise, I will be watching the chat while I paint. But without further ado, I think I am going to pull up my art program. So now, I don't know if you can see. I'm gonna wait for the lag to catch up, just so I can see what you can actually see, because I do have references pulled up. Did I do that? I did not. Okay, that's my bad. I got it. Sorry about that. Just need to see what references you can see on stream, just so I know what I'm working with. There we go. Okay, so you can't see any references. That is unfortunate. Well, what I do have references up is skin palette, and a leather jacket that I used to paint this. Now, some of this is going to be a little hard to see, just because of what I was working with in terms of... I did. It's just very hard to see. Okay, yeah. So I do apologize. Alright, there we go. So, we're gonna start in and start filling in Miss Angel over here. Who is having a rough go of it. Basically, this is a piece of my own making. Okay, ooh, that is a lot lighter than I was hoping for. She is a pale woman. Not woman. She's a pale not woman. Trying. There we go. That's a lot closer to what's going on. There we go. Alright. So I'm just going to very quickly slide into here and erase what isn't supposed to be there. Because that... Oh... I did not do the actual layer for the skin. That's my bad. Alright, there we go. Angel skin. So let's... Just very quickly... Do that. We're not. We're gonna have to fill this in a little bit. That's alright. There we go. Awesome. Now, long term, this piece is actually, like, the moment, it's one of those pieces that's very, seconds before disaster, if you will. So we're not going to be going too far into deets on what's happening, as long as I can remember that is the decision I've made, of course. Now, along with the heat, I am just, again, a little bit more prefacing. I woke up a little disoriented, so if I'm a little out of it, a little tired, I have done my best to find some caffeine. And this is not caffeine, but worst comes to worst, I will get up, take a break, and when we take our break, grab some. Because it is unreasonably, like, not my day. You know? And that's alright. That happens. Some days are just not your day. There we go. Alright. There we go. Now, technically, I don't have to fill in under the lines, under where the line art is, but that's just something I like to do. So I know that, like, if I decide to remove the lines, which I usually don't, but if I do decide to, I don't have to worry about it looking funky, because there's just white lines in the middle of the piece, you know? So I'm just covering my bases. There we go. And that is all the line art that I need to worry about here, I believe. Now, if you're wondering what that little space there is, where the mouth is, that is going to be an open mouth, so I will be filling that in a different way. Let me next do Angel's hair. Gonna take care of that really quick. Get that out of the way so we at least have some solid stuff going on. There we go, just like that. Kind of what we're going for, except maybe not to that degree of. There we go. So I'm just very briefly going to run my eyes along the hair, because it is dark and not the ideal. Okay, so I think I'm gonna do, actually, for moments like this, I am going to make a cleanup layer. And then use that to be able to see all the lines really clearly. So if you don't like the color red, now is the time to look away, but this is going to be our cleanup layer. There we go. Just like that, we have what we're looking for. And then we'll just turn that layer off, as needed. There we go. And there we get the full sort of vision of kind of what the piece is meant to be. Alright. So now we go into Angel's hair. And we are going to color swatch that. Just make sure that we're not missing anything. That is the last thing we want. Make sure that there's no holes there. Right? Or is it too. Might be too white. There we go. And hopefully, it's a little bit. No, it's not quite off that white enough, so I'm just going to do a different one. There we go. You can a little more easily see those lines right there. You see what I mean? That's what we're going for. And then there we go. You do this. There we go. All right. And I'm just going to again. While I'm here, go over those lines while I'm looking for the sort of openings that I might need to fill in. That's really what we're here to do. There we go. Feel free to let me know if you're working on anything in the chat, what you're working on. I'm always a little bit fascinated and curious about what you guys are working on when we're painting together. As per usual with the art streams, more so than with the other ones, of course, that you're also like, you have a snack that, for example, you take a break to stretch, which we're gonna do halfway through the stream. That sort of thing. Very, very important to your well-being. I will say, Tonight, unrelated to art, I am currently really looking. We're currently really looking forward to tonight's D&D game that we have, because it is. We're literally role playing Tag, the game Tag. And it's been a really good diffuser from what the campaign has been for the last, like, half a year for us, which is combat. And combat's fun. Don't get me wrong. It's a lot to navigate when that is the only thing you're doing. You know what I mean? So we're just taking a good break from that, and we were going to do, like, one free session of just whatever. Like, and in-game, in-world tattoos included, but, we're actually really happy with what we're doing at the moment. So we're looking forward to tonight. We're just gonna continue the game of Tag. Very excited. There we go. There we go. All right. Now we have that. That's not going to bother us. Theoretically, if we want. I think I didn't clean up the line art as well as I meant to, but I think I did it for the most part at least good enough that at this point I can pretty safely turn off that cleanup layer and do that. We have that white. There we go. And then just because this is not the hair, this is a jacket. We're gonna do that, and there we go. Now I'm not too worried about doing brows, just to sort of show that I am not entirely forgetting about them. We're going to tilt this a little bit this way and get those brows in. Real quick, we're gonna make these a separate layer just in case I need to clean them up and they go under the hair. There we go. There we go. Now, this isn't the stark white that her hair is actually, that Kier hair is actually supposed to be, but. That's alright. I will be highlighting it really well, when it comes time to shade. Because your hair is white. Very specifically, in world, the reason I've given for that being because this character that I'm painting right now, that I'm doing this, the hair up, really likes a challenge, and what is a better challenge beyond getting black hair dye out, than trying to get white in? So, that's what this is about. So I'm just gonna try to make, accentuate that white. When we get to shading. Once we're done cleaning up the brows, then we'll move on to the next thing. There we go. There we go. And that actually looks pretty even for brows. So I think. I'm gonna leave it there. I'm gonna leave that there in terms of brows. Awesome. I do think under the skin we need to do the mouth. Angel's mouth. We're just going to just a pretty dark. Just inside. Just for that small little area. And then we can go forward. There we go. Oh, nope, wrong tool. Okay, there we go. So now we're gonna save this. We have that. Now, what we're gonna paint next, because as per usual, we are gonna do all of each character bits first. We're gonna do Angel's hoodie. And go from there. Now, I very specifically, when I painted this, went bright gray, because Angel's sort of color scheme is very much like whites, light pinks, that sort of thing. So we want to make sure we are highlighting that. Oh, yeah, yes. Okay. So I need to make sure I actually plug this up. Okay. Oh, nope. That is too big. Let's go. Let's clean this up. And now, theoretically, I should be good. Huh. No, okay. So let's see, where did I not get the line art sort of totally cleaned up? I am, by the way, going to do my absolute best to make sure that, I'm not tilting the computer screen very much, although there may come moments where I need to, just to make sure I'm seeing everything quite right. So I might be angling my face a little weirdly every once in a while. I'm just a little bit stuck is all. Okay, there we go. Okay, and then we just do this. Okay, so I don't think, oh, there was also a little hole here that I needed to plug up. Am I correct? No, I'm still missing more. Okay. Alright. So it's not even really going into that shirt, I don't think. So I'm not gonna worry about it too much. I'll worry about that when I get to his skin, which is considerably less pale than Kim. He does only use neopronouns, by the way. When I made this character, I did the one thing that every sort of non-binary person character writer, the highest honor that we can give, and that is I gave this person my neo pronouns, just because I was like, oh, this is a menace to society and is a freaking disaster, doing your best. I adore this character. He's also a disaster. And I just had an itch. My partner and I, my writing partner and I, have been doing a lot of writing for these characters as of late. So I wanted to pull from that pool of writing that we've done recently. Admittedly, this piece is not from current scenes that we've written recently. We've written those scenes semi-recently. Before. And we're currently on a different arc of storylines. But this is also, like, I'm getting so much serotonin out of, like, writing this set of characters, which, for a while, for example, because we do have characters that we wrote for so long that, we sort of reached a point of, like, what else do we write with them? We've written their epilogue many times over. We need something new to work with. And then we made this. We sat for a while, not really sure what we wanted to write. And then we stumbled upon the equivalent of, like, a vigilante equivalent of, like, Alcoholics Anonymous. Where instead of drinking a lot, it's a case of, like, going out and perhaps hurting people a little bit more than you should, or, like, just in the sake of, like, protecting people and justice and that sort of thing. Because I think we knew that we wanted to do a superhero world, but in a way that we hadn't done yet, because we have done a superhero AU of our previous characters. But yeah, so we sat on our writing for a while, actually, before we stumbled upon that concept, and we just built, and we built, and we built, and we haven't stopped building, and I've been having so much fun with it. Like, it's been a delight. Oh, I found it. There we go. Now. Okay. So it's not perfect, but at least in regards to the hands, we found the hole. We found what we needed to plug up. Okay. So, there we go. We got there. And in the very least, now we can pretty safely do that. Although we're actually going to make sure that's properly cleaned up. There we go. Now the fun thing about this streaming, is that this coming Wednesday, the Wednesday coming up, I am actually going to be doing a fun stream, hopefully, technology willing, of course, with my girlfriend. We're going to be playing, Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes, mostly, admittedly, inspired by, Call Me Kevin, who I thoroughly enjoy the content of. He's very, very funny, and he played it with his chat and his stream, I just thought that to be a really compelling idea, except, you know, obviously, small chat, and that's fine, but my girlfriend also streams, so in the very least, I will be playing that, Wednesday, or trying to, and it's gonna be a blast. I just know it. Okay, just like with before, with the fingers and the skin, I am making sure that I sort of put that gray under the lines, just so I know that I'm not going to get any weirdness going on. Which, weirdness is fine in most cases. I embrace weird, I love weird. But, not this kind of weird. Okay, let me make this a smaller brush then. There we go. And then we're just going to make sure that this has been covered, background has been covered, that is. And we're going to, just to make this a little easier on myself, I'm going to do this. There we go. There we go. Awesome. Now we have that sweatshirt done. And under that, you're going to be doing... Ooh. Don't mind that. Pants shading. Angel's pants. I'm very briefly just going to move the angel hair things so that it's all one layer, the brows and the hair. And then maybe I'm gonna move this over the hoodie. Yeah. Just so I'm not as worried. Okay. Awesome. Next, what we're doing is the sweatpant. Now, theoretically, there shouldn't be too much to do. I don't think there's anything I need to clean up, per se. Also, should be good. Okay. Now, what was that? What color was I going for? I think it was a little closer. Sure about that? Okay. Let's know. That is not the gig. Okay. So I must have messed up somewhere along here. Not a funky fan of this, but okay. So once again, we're just gonna line around this and go from there. I also don't think this is the color I originally had in mind for those sweatpants. But that's alright. It's like a more like a dusty pinky, almost pinky purple. And now we're working with a darker purple. So Angel's not wearing pink, Angel's wearing a little bit of purple. We're just going to... We do also have Angel's shoes to paint as well, which we will do next. Because then we can move on to the prick McGee that's pinning her. That's pinning him. This is not a positive moment from our writing, to say the least. So I just want to make sure that that's clear. Awesome. That half's done. Awesome. Just want to make sure. Okay. We should be solid on this. No. Okay. So it's on. Is it on this side that it's getting weird? I think it's on this side that it's getting weird. Okay, and then I'm not seeing anything on the arm that I'm trying to avoid. So I'm just going to ignore that for now. And then we'll recircle back to it. I'm not quite sure where the bleed over is coming from. Okay. Oh, okay. No, we're good. Okay. And then... this. No, I might have gone over just a little bit. I did. Okay. And then I think if I use the fill tool again now, it, so it's not that. Okay. This is bonkers. I don't know why that's happening, but we're going to fix it. We're gonna figure it out. There we go. We're just going to do this, and then we'll clean that up a little bit more. Clean that up a little bit. Fill in little spots. There we go. And there's what we're looking for. Because Key's not going to get the chance to really do anything else with that other leg. So what's left is to paint the shoe. Welcome to the chat, any lurkers who might have just joined, by the way. I hope you're enjoying this, even as a background. Alright, so now, with that, we're actually going to fill this in. Right there. But with shoes, not really where I put most of my detail, and that's alright. But what's left now is we can move on to the other guy here, whose name is Cole, and he is not a good dude. He is not a good man by any means. Okay, I also think I missed a little bit of cleanup, so I'm very quickly just going to take care of that. There we go. Alright, so now let's pop into that skin tone. And pick something that we can work with. So let's see. Okay. I mean, that definitely works. That works. Okay. So we're at least gonna do this here. And then we'll build our way up. And you can sort of see the line without it being, like, interrupting what's really happening. Which is the goal. Just something that's off enough that you can see the lining, but from a distance, it's not distracting. It's not distracting. Something for me to sort of create shape with, without sacrificing anything else. Alright. Yes, we have our nose. We have our nose. Hell yes. Awesome. So I'm just going to fill that in, so we're not worried about that. And then fill that in just a little bit. Get as much of this sort of sorted out as possible. Again, this is where the head tilting comes in. and then we just make sure that we're touching up to where that line is. Alright, now let's see what happens there. There we go. Awesome. And now, instead of where I had a mouth under this, under him, under Angel's skin layer, I'm gonna have Cole's eye. Because that's where we really want to make sure. Alright. So the way that he was described to me by my partner who writes this character, is he has onyx eyes, which, as I recall, So this is mostly so that we can. So that eye is not actually going to stay that big. Do not worry. This is for blending purposes. And we're going to blend that in just a little bit. Just so we can get a good base to work with. I've been doing something with the eyes that I've been painting recently that I'm actually really, really pleased with. It always comes out really cool. Or at least cool to me, and it adds a little bit of dimension. I've been adding just little splats of like different like color and gradation. Because then it's more of like a real eye that like has light reflecting on it. We get to see that shading. And then just going. Yeah, already that looks better. That looks better to me already. And then from there, we're going to bring out pure white. And then we're just going to do this. We're gonna make sure that he looks a little bit demonic, because he is a terrible, terrible person in this world that he's in. So we're gonna leave his eyes just a little bit bigger than I normally would. But oh wait, no. I just had the realization. I just had a thought. He would be looking down. I didn't place that right. That's on me. There we go. So let's see how that looks. That looks a little better. Yeah, that looks a little better. Now it's not creating the Picasso or anything, but all right. So then we have. So I'm gonna do his hair mostly, so then I can put everything else under it without worrying about bleeding into it. But it will, like with Angel's hair, be over top of the clothing, very specifically because it falls over the clothing. But we're talking. Let's see. How's this? Is that a little too dark? There we go. Yeah, that'll do. That will do. Okay. That'll do as a base. And then we are going to lean into it when we go into shade. If we go in with pure black now, we can't shade. Which is the only really frustrating thing about this. We really, really want him to want to know that he looks like a bad boy, sort of a thing. That is the description I was given. Like an actually like freaking soulless bad boy, instead of the way people usually depict them, rescuing kittens and such, you know. All right. Cause brows. So we're gonna do that real quick too, on a different layer, of course. In a few minutes, we're just gonna take 2 to 3 to 4 minutes, just to stretch to make sure that we're not hurting our bodies with the way we're sitting. I know I am. Do not sit like I am. And that's all right. All right, let's go. All right. Then we're gonna pull this in. So we're just going to make sure that he looks fucking angry as hell. And I believe, like, once we carve the brow that I just put it down a little bit, we have achieved that. And then, there we go. Alright, so now we're just going to very, with ease, just sort of slide into it. He's a very pretty guy. In that bad boy way, so we want to keep him a little bit groomed, but he is very specifically meant to look a little bit, unhinged, I believe is the phrasing I'm going to use here. So we're not gonna keep him looking too tidy, too cleaned up. There we go. Alright, there we go. Now, it's not perfect by any means. Brows are not going to be, like, incredible on this piece. The angle's a little bit weird, and I'm not quite used to working with that angle. That's alright, though. That already looks a little better. So we're just going to combine these layers. We are going to move on to his shirt. Because he does have a shirt. He's also got that one layer of, like, that leather jacket that he's got going on. He's got that working for him, too. Specifically, because he wants it to look pre-worn. But, no, he has daddy's money. That is the exact reasoning. There we go. Awesome. Alright, now, we'll do pants last, just because it's going to take a little bit of extra time. But, cold jacket. We're then going to go into, the coloring of the jacket. Because we aren't going to give him the dignity of his jacket being the right thing. Now, you weren't able to see what I'm working with. But that's okay. Basically what we're working with here is a chocolatey brown. Just like that. Okay. Oh, we did not do his hands. Oh boy, okay, we'll circle back to that. We will. But let's then fold that in. Now that's fixed. And then we're just going to make sure, once again, we've sort of filled in this line here under it. There we go. There we go. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. That's not going to be the perfect leather, like, leather jacket look, but that's alright. Being gentle with ourselves. Wait. Did I fuck it up? Oh, okay. So, we're going to go in. Smaller tool. And we're just going to get in some of those finer details without mucking up the other stuff. The this little thing. Very specifically, just taking care of this area. I do find myself very tempted to pull this into my lap, pull it really close to my face, but I'm doing my very best not to. Okay. Oh, very close to getting that right. But no. Okay. So I'm just going. So filling the jeans as well, which I normally want. Not today. Lining it so we're not interrupting anything. There we go. Awesome. So we have that area sort of filled in. I'm gonna do this area next. So I don't know where that's coming from, where that bleed over came from. So I'm just going to make sure that all of this is sort of covered. Once we have the jacket filled in, we will take like a 3 to 4 minute break, get stretches, get snacks, get whatever we need, and then we will revisit the hands. So I don't want to leave those unattended for too long. A, as a character, he will hurt someone with them, and B, he, I will forget fairly quickly. No. Okay, so I keep going, looking, going over. Because they're not the same, but they are pretty close in color. And it's hard to tell this close to the line with that much to work with for comparison. Awesome. Now, let's see what happens when I do it now. No, okay. So, it's that area down at the bottom. Because it doesn't seem to cover everything, unless I've already forgotten, because my brain doesn't like to work like a normal person's brain. But, we'll color this in very carefully. Make sure that we're getting in the lines just to prevent the extra cleanup. And then let's just see for kicks and giggles. I see the problem. There we go. Alright. Now let's see. Awesome! Awesome! Better. Better. Alright. I am going to step away just for a minute so I can stretch. I'm going to recommend that you do the same thing. And we will be back to fix his hands. I will see you in 3 to 4 minutes. just give me a moment. I just need to take care of one more thing and we can hop right back in. Some important things coming up. I do need to be able to check. I need to check my phone a little bit. All right, live. It's all right. There we go. All right. So now what's left? What's what we're doing before we do the legs, and the pants? We actually need to hop back into that skin layer. And perfectly match this. Or rather, need to match this. Let's see. I just want to make sure I'm getting... No, that's a little too light. You know what? I'll take it. It's like almost impossible to tell the difference. So I'm just going to go with that one. There we go. And then we do that. We have that going on. Alright. So now that we have that, let's actually do this bit where we color under the lines, and once we've done that we can actually hop and do some of the fun stuff. Alright, there we go. And then we go over to the other hand. There we go. There we go. There we go. We're actually going to make sure that this gets colored in too. There we go. Awesome. There we go. Alright, we're getting some fingers in there. We are almost done with this layer. I just need to make sure that all of those lines are colored under. I do hope that you took the time to stretch and get a snack. I know I certainly did. Well, not the snack thing, because I can't talk and eat at the same time. But, you know, got that done. Alright. Then we have pants. Cole's pants. Alright, so let's go into this color set. It's like super dark, almost black. If not, actually. Just like that. There we go. Okay. So, I think... Okay, I will wait to go into that one, just because I'll show you why. It's a very design, very particular part of the design that was mentioned, so I want to stay true to it. So I just want to make sure I'm respecting that. Because this is not my character, it is my partner's. I want to make sure I'm respecting the character design that I've been given to work with. Okay, and now we can fill that in. Because I will be doing a, like, just barely lighter tone in that area. So, please let me know if anything needs to be adjusted. As per usual, I am looking for that just to make sure everyone's doing all right. There we go. Okay. And so now, with that in mind, we're going to do a little bit of that and that. There we go. We're gonna fill these in. Awesome. And then, the only thing that's left under that, beyond the weapon in his hand, is his shoes. Cole's shoes. Okay. Now, I admit, with the posing of this, I wasn't quite sure how it was going to turn out, but I like it better than I was expecting to. Which is a win that I will take. So let's see what we're working with there. Okay. So it's a little more gray than black. That's okay. Alright. Okay. And then we're just going to make sure that we get those tiny little details in over here where the other side of the where the other side of this is. Right. There we go. Wasn't sure what boots to do for him. So I just went with the standard boots that I'm used to painting. And then, last but not least, over top of the pants is where I'm actually going to put the knife. Because that, is the most important part of this. There we go. There we go. Alright, we're just going to that in real quick, and then I'll just do a little bit more cleanup right around here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. And now, other than the background, because the background is going to be a whole separate beast, because I do want to do something fun with the background. Other than the background, I am pretty happy with this as a base. So I think I'm ready to start working on shading. So let's save this one more time before I do anything else. We're going to show this. Okay. Okay, so one thing I didn't do is shirt. Oh, shoe. Okay. And little shoe. Okay. Sorry. Okay, there we go. So we're gonna do angel skin shading layer. Oh gosh. That's the one thing I didn't crack while I was standing. That's alright. Alright, so we're gonna look at very specifically your skin. Here we have like a pale pinky. So let's get a look at what that looks like on them. Okay. So yeah, probably doesn't need to be that pinky. Let's see. Still a little too bright. That seems a little bit more correct. No, okay. What was the skin tone that I had before? There, okay. So then let's set this opacity to 90, as per usual when we're doing shading. Alright. And we're just going to slide on in there. Yeah, alright, there we go. We're just going to shade that in. And with this one, we can stand to be a little less precise for a little bit, depending on where. But not everywhere. Usually, with the first layer that one paints, shades, that is the place where you can probably, maybe not go ham wild, hog wild, of course, but you know, probably relax a little bit with where you're putting that shading, in terms of like going over the line at least. And then we're going to make that tool a little bit bigger. Okay. Now with Angel, very specifically, the shape of your cheeks are, so we're just going to do it this way because Key's got some stronger cheeks. Some stronger cheekbones. So I can probably pretty safely put that there. In terms of that. Now, I'm gonna pop this back into 90 and set this angling back to 0. Because I don't know what the hell that is. We're gonna set this to 2 because this is not a big mouth, and even where it is considerable, we're not gonna give it too much thought at the moment. Already we're doing that, just a little bit of that. We're just going to go to the hands. There we go. We're gonna set that tool back to 6 because that is so much simpler. And for now, it works and it does what we need it to do. For now, I'm also, for me, going to turn off the reference even if you guys can't see it because I don't need it anymore. Gosh, it's the one downside to painting, like, it's very hard with lighter colors, it's harder to see. And well, I am absolutely trying to up the diversity on what I'm painting. As an established character, you know? It would be inauthentic. And I don't know that I could respectfully write. I don't know that I would know how to make sure I'm not, like, bumping into anything, you know? So we're good there for that for now. So Angel's face probably doesn't need to be overly detailed. That being said, we're just going to make sure that you can really tell where some of the stuff is. We're gonna 45 degree angle some of that shit. There we go. Alright. And then we're just going to make sure that we're doing that right. There we go. Okay. Now, with that first set of shading lines done, we are going to A, set that tool to 7 instead of what it was before. We're gonna set the opacity to 45. Just so it can like go out a little bit further, little bit lighter, and we can extend that shading out a little bit farther. More bang for our buck, if you will, you know? Okay, there we go. I am very much looking forward to tomorrow. I said I do have a job interview for somewhere that's a little closer to home that I can actually reach a little better. So I have some stuff going on I'm looking forward to. Okay, now we are going back over here and doing that same thing. Not on the fingers, because we don't need to do that with the fingers. Begin up with the sides of the hands that can be cleaned up with the cleanup layer that I've made. That's just where we're going to do that bit. And we're going to make sure that we're like, there's some real dimension and shape in this hand, in these hands, in that face. There we go. There we go. Alright. There we go. And now we're sort of seeing that. We're just going to... I'm actually going to make that a little bit wider. But with that, now, we can actually probably start putting some of that shading in. There we go, that lighting in. We can set that 75, because that's where I set my lighting. My lighting opacity. Depending on how light it is. There we go. Awesome. Now I'm just going to make this tool a little smaller. So that we can get it on the fingers. Just a little bit here. Just a little bit. Awesome. There we go. Now we're just going to go into that other. We're gonna go across the face and we're gonna start putting that lighting in there too. There we go. And then we can pop a little that there. Just, it's might be a little much, but I'm a little less concerned with that at the moment. It lights up the face a little bit. There we go. Alright, and now we hop back in. Now we hop to... this. And then we're gonna get that to the 6th size tool. And we're just gonna do this. And now what's left is to blend. And shall we blend? I believe we shall. Alright. Regardless, if Angel's skin is the only thing we really get to shade today, I made a lot of progress. I did all the base coloring, I made sure that everything was clean. cleaned up enough that I could do that without having to worry too much about bleed over, which is a lot, which there was a lot to do. Let's not underestimate how much there actually was that I began with. So I'm pretty pleased with that. So I'm actually going to pull up that cleanup layer just so I can make sure I'm getting a really good idea of where I need to clean up. There we go. There we go. Alright. Awesome. Now that should be mostly cleaned up, if not entirely. There we go. And there we have that hand. And later I will probably come back. I've been starting to come back later at the end of a piece just to sort of highlight, put any extra little bit of low lighting of like, oh, there's not enough like there for shading or that sort of thing. Where I might have been a little bit more stingy about it before. There we go. There we go. Alright. And then, oh dear. So I don't know why it's on my mind at the moment, but does anyone here watch Lock and Key? Anyone? Because Lock and Key is currently on the brain, and I'm pretty sure it's just because we saw one of the actresses in that show in a procedural that Ed was watching yesterday. The mom, I believe, who was watching CSI Miami, which we watch mindfully, of course, trying to be aware of what's in it. But yeah, it's currently on my mind, and it's very interesting. I don't even know that I have, real thoughts on my head about it. But it's, sort of obsessively there. Pay attention to me. Pay attention to me. I think I'm gonna go into shading. Go into a little bit more shading. Now, actually. Because this is not doing enough for me. They aren't sticking out enough. I want this sort of effect. There we go. It's a little harder to ignore because everything else is so pale, you need to add in a little bit of extra shading just to make sure that you're not losing sight of the shape. Just because someone is white does not mean they're paper white. If you're paper white, I'm mildly concerned about how much sun you're getting, you know? We do want to create that sort of shape that would be there. Alright, so we're going to make that tool a little smaller again, and we're just going to make sure that we blend that out. We're gonna blend that out. I might make that a little bit bigger, just because it's a little underblended until you get in a bigger tool there. There we go. Alright. There we go. Alright. And that is already much better than I, with the little crevices that I'm trying to hope to, when I zoom out, See? That is a lot better. That is a lot better. You can see a lot more. The effect of shading is very specifically, so from a distance you're like, oh, that's a hand. Those were moving fingers. Those are like, yeah. So we're just going to pop that in here too. Alright. Another thing that I've been catching myself interested in, is royalty soaps. The YouTube channel, it turns out that it's very good for my brain. For example, tonight or last night, I was watching a show, and I like it had nothing to do with the show, but I saw like a post while I was watching it, but because I was scrolling while I was, you know how you do, and it sent me down on like a mini spiral of like, you know how sometimes you just get super excited over a character and like you can't turn your brain off from just like vibrating out of joy thinking about it? That happened to me, which I usually don't mind, but like when it's happening at like 3 to 4 at night, not really helpful. Because you need to go to sleep. I needed to go to bed so that I could be a person. And so that happened, and I was like basically about to vibrate out of my skin or something. And I like turned on royalty soaps. I was like, maybe that'll help slow down my brain. And it did. It did. It got rid of like, it didn't totally get rid of it, but it like sort of reset my brain enough to like go, oh, okay. My brain is at normal speed. I'm not vibrating at the sonic sound at like enough to like create a sonic boom, which is effectively what might as well have happened. Thankfully that doesn't happen very often, because I genuinely think that would make it very difficult to function, but it was fun. And it's a very good fix for when that happens. It's very ASMR. And the lady who runs the channel, is so sweet. Like, extremely sweet. She's so cute. I love her so much. She makes really creative designs. She's, like, got so much energy that I don't know how she has. And it's very interesting. Like, I just, yeah. Thankfully, my brain doesn't create that chemical that makes me go, I want to get a bunch of soap supplies and start making soap for the next, like, 4 days, and then I don't do it anymore. But, like, beyond that, like, she's very good at what she does. And it's very good for my brain. So, like, I don't know. It's a phenomenon. And I appreciate the phenomenon because I need that sort of fix. Break glass in case of emergency, if you will. You know? You need that sometimes. Alright, now this is already sort of creating that shape that I was hoping for. Yes. No. I think I'm actually not as pleased with that. Okay, so maybe if I go down to 10. I'm gonna go down to 10 and see what happens. See how I feel. Yeah. I like that better. I like that a lot better. There we go. Already, that is miles better than I was experiencing just a moment ago. At least around the nose, I want that to be more distinct. So that it is a little bit more like, oh yes, there's the shape of the face. everything else, not that it can go itself, but it's not as important to me to get that the distinctness of those shapes. Let me see if I can get a bigger blending tool just for... There we go. Okay, yeah. Awesome. Okay, so we have that. That nose is actually a lot better than I was expecting. Alright. Oh, I don't think there's anything for me to clean up on there. Very specifically because of the way that was handled and the layer that is, because that is the first layer on this piece, so that doesn't have as much to clean. So I'm gonna save this, and then I am actually going to end the stream there, just because that feels like a good place to stop. If you liked this stream, I will be uploading the VOD on Clockwork System on YouTube directly after the stream. If you would like to see the more updated art as I upload it, I can't promise that I'm as good about updating Instagram, but it is there if you want to see it. Clockwork Sis. And if you made anything alongside me, or you would like to tag me in a game that you would like to see me play, you can tag us at clockwork_sis on twitter.com. I absolutely look forward to hearing any suggestions you might have. Thank you for joining me. This has been a delight, and I hope that you guys have enjoyed your time watching and listening to this, however it is that you do so. Have a lovely day. I will see you on Monday.